Hello, good morning, and thank you for coming at the presentation of my thesis. I will talk you about the work I've done in Terrassa and the laboratory of Professor Xavier Giraud in the University Politecnica of Catalonia, and also for Vilaweb Television, which is actually the leader of Catalan information by the website. Then our goal is to create a new platform for delivering media through the internet and also to allow live streaming using the peer-to-peer delivery method. This for particular reasons that I will explain later when we will analyze each single point of my work. Then I began my work with studying the state of the art of the solution that actually are available in the market. And then I understood that there are different ways to encode audio and video, and the difference main stands on the type of codec which is used. A codec can be better than another, maybe if because there are some parameters, which are the sample rate, the bit rate, and the kind of compression. Then for audio, the main type of codec are MP3, AAC, which stands for Advanced Video Codec, which is an extension of MP3, and actually is considered better, and Vorbis, which is an open source one, also very interesting. What about video? It is possible to use the H264 video codec, which is open source and very, very good. Otherwise, Windows Media Video or Theora are other commonly used formats. Then we need to package the audio with the video together, and then we will use a container. And the main containers are MP4, which is used also by the Google Video System, as for OGG. OGG is the open source one, and it's also very powerful. Then, to make a video available, it is possible to use different possibilities. It is possible to direct download the video, as in these examples, there are a lot of videos. We can imagine that a Dunkin' Donuts is a video, then we can just go there and direct download it. An example, it is the iTunes Music Store, then we just download the songs from their server, or with a YouTube video website, we can download the video, for example, of the Vilaweb very, very easily, directly into our machine. Otherwise, it is possible to create a podcast website that contains a gallery of videos. And each time that a video is added into our gallery, it will be automatically downloaded into the user's podcast reader. And then what happened is that when the user will go back home in the evening, maybe he can see all the new videos that were created in this day and choose what to see. Then BlueChomes is an example of an open source podcast system that can be easily installed on any Unix machine. And with one installation, it is possible to create many podcast site. Otherwise, WordPress is a widely famous podcast system, and it is possible also to upload videos and to create a video podcast gallery. Or the broadcast machine, it is, I think, the best solution for create a podcast website for collecting videos. And I experimented this, I tried the solution, and I will show you later the work I did. Then iTunes has introduced recently the iPhone, and maybe also other companies will create similar products, and then it will be possible automatically download the podcast from the internet and then upload them to the mobile device and then look at them everywhere, on the street, on the taxi, on the bus, on the airplane, and so the content will be available on request every time. Otherwise, it is possible to show the TV, the videos also at home using the Apple's new created television system. But this solution will be available starting from February on. Then it is possible to create a peer-to-peer network. This is a particular solution, as the videos are made available through the network by the clients itself, and it means that it doesn't exist the world of client or server, but exists only equal peer nodes that are sharing some files. The most common and more famous examples can be a mule, Napster, Kazaa, Morpheus, a donkey, and so on. But the most important thing for us is the BitTorrent protocol. It was written always by the same author of the peer-to-peer protocol, and it tries to bring the peer-to-peer distribution method also to the web, because it consists on a torrent file that you can find on a website, then download it and open it with a BitTorrent client. And then what will happen is that your computer will connect to a central tracker where is stored the information about the location, the actual location of the file through millions of computers. In this picture I can show, for example, these are all the computers. This is the torrent tracker, which knows where are all the pieces of the file. And these are us that will get some file from this, and so on. Then examples are the Zudeo system, which is open source. It is written by the French company Azureus, and it is possible to publish torrent files and make video galleries available for all the users through the network. Another example is the Democracy Player, and this is a client to connect to a podcast site and to download the videos if they are on in a torrent format or also in the common in a common video format. And then the user won't recognize if they are torrents or videos, because they will be just downloaded directly into the machine without any effort. The Venice project is a nice, it's another nice solution. It is written by the authors of Skype and Kazaa, and there are actually some video galleries available, mainly by some important television companies, and it is possible to peer-to-peer download these videos into our machine, show them, see them when they want, and make these videos available for other people which will download the videos from our machine, and so on. And in my solution, this will be one of the killer applications of the internet for tomorrow. Then, the other, our goal was to experiment new ways to stream a video signal through the internet.